say that obviously, being a born-again Christian and reading the scripture, I would believe that homosexuality is wrong.
Okay.
That's obvious. But there is a higher realm than that. Jesus hung out with prostitutes and with sinners. Jesus became known a friend of prostitutes and sinners. The commandment of scripture is to love. My heart, I don't even think of all these different things. My heart just beats with love and compassion for every single person. And that's where the church has got it wrong, is the church is like, if you like, are this judgmental, we should be doing this, we shouldn't be doing that. I've forgotten that God is love. And that is the thing that I wanted to break coming in here, because there are people that think, oh, you're a born-again Christian, or you're, you know, someone over here that's a religious person, straight away they're going to be against X, Y, and Z. Corinne, can I ask you a question? Since we've been in here, have you felt that in any way I have judged you regarding, you know, who you are and your sexuality?
No, you've always asked me, spoke about Rachel, I feel like I can speak about Rachel with you, like, not got a problem with you whatsoever.
Do you feel like a lack of ease talking about your relationship with Rachel with me?
No.
In any way?
No. Well, then I wouldn't with anyone.
Because she's a private person.
I'm going to say no one in here is trying to say you're homophobic.
Oh, guys, we're all arguing in the bedroom, so I'm going to stay here.
You what? Really?
I didn't what?
What about now?
Oh. About Dave's religious views and homosexuals.
He said he don't mind them, but he just won't marry them.
Yeah.
Are you okay with them?
Yeah, of course.
Cheers, Holmes.
Are you going for a walk?
You go roll some fags.
At the end of the day, I don't really care if anyone thinks my lifestyle choice is sinful or not. I'm still going to do it.
Go on, Josie, you can do it.
Come on, Josie.
For today's task, housemates will take part in a series of man versus machine challenges. If housemates lose their individual battle, they'll become robots and will not take part in the final battle between housemates and Big Robot. Housemates have chosen Josie to take on Titan in the first challenge, an epic battle of carpet cleaning. If man or machine completely clear their carpet of maggots first, they'll be victorious.
Corinne, are you loving it?
Loving it. I've been wanting to stop now and dancing.
Game over. This is Big Robot. Big Robot has deemed that machine is victorious. Josie, you are now a robot. Put on your outfit and return to the house.
She had no chance of winning that. It had a proper big hoover. It's just like that, weren't it?
And it weren't even like the crappy hoover they gave us.
Proper good one.
Do you know what I mean?
Josie has been a robot for 16 minutes.
That thing is scary, Keith.
Yeah, I'd say he is. Really scary.
Oh, Keith.
What?
I got a wedge.
Oh. Will I pull it out?
And my cacks as well.
Is your knickers?
Yeah.
Will I pull them out?
Yeah. That's it. Thanks.
Yeah?
Yeah. Thanks for that one.
You're welcome anytime.
Most of the housemates are in the living room.
David? Going for a cigarette?
Is everyone coming out?
I'm coming.
Just noticed another point about your character, Ben.
What?
You expect me to share all my things with you, but you don't even offer me a piece of your apple.
I did offer you a piece of apple. No, he specifically asked if he wanted some apple.
No,
you
offered me some. He said, do you want a bit of my apple?
You asked me before.
I watched it. No, I don't want any.
I've offered you, I often offer you coffee.
You're just basically, at the very core of your being, a selfish person. But it's okay.
That's not true.
I can accept that about you.
I'm not selfish at all. Whenever I make a tea or coffee, I always ask Dave, I always ask Steve, and I always ask you. You very rarely want one, so you can't hold that against me.
You've done that, like, you've started doing it in the last 2 days.
And I only borrow a lot of your clothes, because you've got a lot of clothes, and I've got none. If I had a lot of clothes and you had none, I'd expect that you'd ferret through my drawers. True?
No, not at all.
Well, why wouldn't you?
Because I wouldn't want to wear other people's clothes.
No, but what if you didn't have any of your own? You wouldn't have any choice.
No, it doesn't matter.
I can't believe I'm in trouble because I didn't give you a piece of apple.
Did I say you're in trouble?
No, but you said...
I just said...
There are more and more things I'm beginning to dislike about you each day. By the end of the week, I could quite possibly despise you.
I don't speak like that, Ben. Nor do I pretend to put a fake Sloane Square accent on.
You're being a bitch today. I've done absolutely nothing wrong. I've let you have your love in with your robots all day. I haven't said a thing about that. You've bit my tongue.
Huh? Good.
I've bit my tongue.
You won't.
Sorry, I didn't mean to annoy you over the apple.
You
I'm sorry.
You won't just open up and share everything.
It's not annoying me when you reveal parts of your character.
Yeah. Expresses everything that's in his heart.
13:21.
I am a robot. Do you fancy her?
No.
No.
Oh.
No. Affirmative.
What the? Not very strong, is it?
Just pretend.
Hello, Mario.
Hello, big robot.
How are you today?
Oh, I'm very happy today. This morning when we woke up, you opened the door and Titan was standing there. That was just amazing. I think that's probably one of my personal highlights of being in the house, having Titan come to life. Can we keep him as a permanent housemate?
Which housemate would you like to replace for Titan?
Yeah, let's replace him with Ben.
Dave and Ben are in the nest talking about Mario.
What is wrong with him?
I don't know, he's going a bit weird, isn't he?
He's always been weird.
He's weirding out.
He's strange, man.
And notice when I did an impression of his accent, he said, I don't talk like that. But he does. He does talk like that. He's like a mixture of Michael Jackson and some librarian woman from Ohio. Like turning on your friend every 5 minutes because they don't offer you a piece of apple. I'm not saying this out of bitchiness, it's fact. In the outside world, I would be friends with someone like you, even though, you know, I'm not born again. I don't share some of your religious views, but I love you so much as a person. You bring so much fun and joy and humour. And then you get old Kenny Everett going mental because I didn't give him a piece of apple. But no, but seriously, serious point though, but what was it that made him so annoyed that I didn't give him a piece of apple?
Because he wants you to return his advances.
Well, it ain't gonna happen. The thing about it, I don't mean to be horrible, but he's quite boring.
Yeah.
Like, he's not very interesting.
As part of today's task, Big Brobot has declared the garden a no-human zone.
Who's going out? If he's not going out either.
Because I'm waiting by the door.
What's going on?
Are you going out, Benji?
Sorry?
Are you going outside?
Well, I promised her I would, so it would be a bit mean not to. I wanted to stay and be lazy and then marry a baby for guilty.
At any time when how.